Hello and welcome to this skilling video on leveraging Azure Blob Storage to bring your data to AI applications through Retrieval Augmented Generation, or RAG. My name is Saurabh Sen Sharma, and I'm a product manager on the Azure Storage Engineering team. Let's dive in. In this video, we are going to walk through techniques to bring domain-specific data and knowledge to LLMs or large language models, zoom into RAG or Retrieval Augmented Generation with unstructured data and storage requirements thereof, and finally, showcase how you can easily leverage Azure Blob Storage for RAG with built-in Azure services integrations, as well as with your own choice of application components. LLMs, or large language models, trained on publicly available data deliver great reasoning and summarization capabilities, but they do struggle to get questions right when it comes to domain-specific data. Users expect current and relevant information from their domain-specific data sets as they get updated, and therefore, bringing domain-specific knowledge to LLMs securely is a key priority and can be achieved in three different ways. Prompt engineering involves modifying the input prompt with contextual information to guide the model's output. Fine-tuning alters the LLM model's weights by retraining with domain-specific data. This is quite like learning new skills to generate outputs in custom styles and formats. And RAG, or Retrieval Augmented Generation, our focus of this video, finds relevant information or facts quickly from your domain data to precisely answer questions and generate content. With RAG, you can use your own data without retraining LLMs, as in fine-tuning, achieving results efficiently while keeping your data secure and protected. At a macro level, RAG combines the generative reasoning capabilities of an LLM with domain-specific knowledge from unstructured sources like text or PDF files or objects, and structured data like databases via a retrieval system and an orchestrator that drives user interaction and augments specific context knowledge to the prompt or query fed into the LLM. Here is a deeper look at the RAG pipeline for unstructured data and interactions involved with storage. First, domain-specific unstructured data is ingested into object storage, cleaned and further chunked into logical fragments or chunks. Data chunking ensures the retrieval stage only extracts the information relevant to the query, thereby making efficient use of the limited context lengths available to LLMs. These chunks represent words, phrases, or entire documents, as well as images, audio, or other types of data, and is converted into vectors or embeddings that are stored in a vector DB. Given a query, the vector DB acts as the retrieval system, performing a vector similarity search across different modalities of data to find the embeddings that are closest to the vector representation of the user query. And then the chunks corresponding to the matched embeddings are securely retrieved from storage and added to the user prompt. And this augmented prompt is then fed into the LLM for a response. Now, as you can see from this diagram, there are several critical interactions in the RAG pipeline that the storage layer needs to support. For RAG, storage needs to deliver the ability to bring multimodal enterprise data to foundation models. It needs to deliver low latency access to the model and relevant data to ensure quick responses given a user query. It needs to have integration with VectorDB functionality, and of course, timely updates to vector search index to ensure responses reflect the current state of your data. And finally, and most importantly, security and access control to prevent retrieval of data by unauthorized users. Now, the good news is Azure Blob Storage effectively addresses all of these requirements with unique capabilities built natively into the platform. Multi-protocol access of Azure Blob Storage allows for heterogeneous updates to data via several protocols without requiring data duplication. Premium Blob Storage offers consistent low latency access, ideal for quick embedding generation and responses, native integration of vector DBs like Azure AI Search, and flexibility to bring your own databases as well via multiple indexes and SDK tools make this the perfect platform for experimentation and tuning your RAG pipeline for quality results. Change notifications and our unique blockchain fate feature guarantees an ordered and consistent log of changes ideal for batch processing and updates in the source domain data and delivers continuous data freshness. And finally, the integration with Azure Entra ID, RBAC or role-based access control, and attribute-based access control or ABAC ensures end-to-end data security. Now, it's time to see all of this in action. We will show how Azure Blob deeply integrates with Azure AI services to help you experiment and build RAG applications with your data very quickly. We will use Azure AI Search as our vector DB, Azure OpenAI Studio as the orchestrator, and OpenAI GPT-3.5 and embedding models to generate vectors and generate responses from the augmented prompts. Let's dive in. All right, so what you're looking at right now is the chat playground, which is the experimentation area within Azure OpenAI Studio. Let's go in and type a query. What is GRID in AI? Now, the LLM, which is GPT-3.5 here, gives me a very creative definition of GRID, but it sounds like the English definition applied to the AI context, which is not necessarily correct. So what we can now do is to ground our LLM by adding a data source, which is our own data. So let's do that. Right from here in setup, I can click add a data source. And as I go to select data source, I can see Azure Blob Storage right here in my selection ribbon. And I can click on Azure Blob Storage, select an Azure Blob Storage resource. Now I have several Blob Storage accounts here. I'll pick one, which is a premium Azure Blob Storage resource. I'll pick a storage container. This is where I have downloaded thousands of PDFs, which are research papers on AI. And now I will select an Azure AI Search resource. And as you can see, it integrates automatically with Azure AI Search as the vector DB here. So I'm going to select a resource. I will give my index a name. Let's say, demo1. And I will add vector search to this search resource. I will select an embedding model. And now I can select a chunk size. As I was saying, you can pick based on the needs of your model and your user query and the outcome that you want to achieve from RAG. But not just this, I can set it up from Azure OpenAI Studio, but I can also go to Azure AI Search, pick my search service. Right here from overview, I can click on import and vectorize data as well. Now, this is a way for you to specify an Azure Blob Storage account and add data to an Azure AI Search index via integrated vectorization. So it'll perform all the chunking, it'll perform all the embedding generations in line with an Azure AI Search. And it's as easy as specifying your storage account, your container, and enabling deletion tracking for freshness. Now, what I've done here is to add a search resource, which is indexed using Azure Blob data via AI Search. And now let's try this query again. What is GRID in AI? And now, as you can see, we get a different response. GRID actually stands for Generative Representational Instruction Tuning, and is a method introduced to unify embedding and generative tasks. So it does have a meaning, and it is pulling this from these references. So this is the PDF file from where this is coming from. I have this PDF file downloaded here, and I see this is consistent with what I expect. So here I was able to combine Azure Blob, Azure AI Search, and OpenAI to be able to deliver a very simple RAG application end-to-end. Now let's look at a very important aspect of RAG applications, which is freshness. Let's go ahead and see how we can deliver freshness with our storage account or Azure Blob Storage behind the scenes. Azure Blob Storage has integration with events and event grid notifications via change notifications. And I can use these event notifications to generate my indexer to be able to perform a re-indexing of my application. And I can do that from this function app that I've deployed as part of my event subscription. Now let's go ahead and delete our PDF that was being used to get the query and its responses. There we go, this has now been deleted. And now what we expect is a re-trigger of our Azure AI search index automatically based on gene notifications. So let's go back and look at our indexer again. So this represents all our indexers here. This one ran 15 seconds ago automatically. And if I go here, I can see that it took a very small period of time because there was a deletion of a PDF. And now if I go back to my chat playground and type this query again, I should hopefully get a different response. What is grit in AI? And this time around it says, I'm sorry, but I could not find any information in retrieved documents because the citation came from a PDF that has now been removed from our knowledge base. And therefore, we were able to quickly update our knowledge base and ensure current data is used for retrieving responses from our domain-specific knowledge base. All right, so in our first demo, we saw how Azure Blob integrates with Azure AI services to deliver RAG. But as it turns out, Azure Blob is a PaaS, a platform as a service solution, and you can use Azure Blob with custom components to develop your RAG applications. Now in this next demo, we will show how you can use LangChain as the orchestrator and Pinecone as the vector DB with Azure Blob Premium Storage to be able to deliver retrieval augmented generation for your AI applications. Let's dive in. All right, so now what we're looking at is some Python code on VS Code where I have hooked up LangChain, Pinecone, and Azure Blob Storage by creating a sample application. And what this application is doing is to process the PDFs from Blob Storage. It processes and stores the chunks into Blob and the vectors into Pinecone, and finally orchestrates the generation of the response. Let's quickly look at some of these functions and see what's going on in here. Within this function, we have a chunk size which is predefined, and I'm using LangChain's recursive character text splitter and PyPDF loader to be able to break down my PDFs, crack them open. And before I do that, I download them from Blob Storage and then split these documents to chunks, and then I return those chunks in this function, right? Now, here is where I generate my embeddings using Azure OpenAI. And this is where I process these chunks by essentially getting them from the previous function call, and then finally uploading those chunks into Blob Storage, generating embeddings for each of those chunks. And then here I upsert those embeddings into Pinecone. It's that easy, right? And then eventually when I need to generate my response, I convert my query to an embedding. So here you can see I'm generating the embeddings for my query. And then based on the matched chunks or embeddings from my vector DB, which is Pinecone here, I get the top 5 high similarity embeddings and get the chunks corresponding to those embeddings from this call, where I download the blob based on what chunk I want to get from my blob storage. Then I retrieve those chunks and append them to my query right here, as you can see. And then that is what is fed into the LLM for response. Great, so let's see this in action. I'm going to query the same thing. Query, what is grit in AI? It got matches, I retrieved some chunks, and there you go. It gives the same consistent response, and as you can see, it gives me even the chunk IDs from where these responses are coming. Now, to demonstrate freshness, let's talk about the fact that when you delete things or change things, you might want to process those changes at the end of the day as batch changes. And that requires you to have an ordered and consistent set of changes that have happened to your domain data. For that, Blob Storage has a very unique feature called change feed. And it's very easy to integrate with change feed through this app as well. So let's take a look at that. So here I have a slightly modified application where I'm doing essentially the same set of things as I was doing in the previous function. But in this case, I'm leveraging change feed to get all changes between the current time or the previous time when change feed was processed. And what I can do is to get the change feed by filtering this feed between a start time and an end time right here, as you can see. And then I can process each of those events in the change feed
by splitting those events between blob creation, blob updation, or even blob deletion. And that allows me to figure out which are the blobs that changed, in what order they changed, and therefore which embeddings need to be updated in my Pinecone vector DB for updated or deleted blobs. This is a function that removes embeddings corresponding to deleted blobs in my knowledge base. And then those deletions essentially update by index and update by response, right? So let's see this again in action. Let's go back to our knowledge base. And this time let's delete this data from here. Now this is deleted. Now we'll go back and run the command for processing the PDFs to capture the changes that change feed was able to capture on the blob storage account. But before we go back to our code and run it again, let me show you how to easily enable change feed for a blob storage account. So this is my blob storage account. I can go to data management. Within data management, I see data protection. Within data protection, I can see enable blob change feed right here. You can also configure how long you want to retain the change feed for so that you can process those batch changes at the intervals that you desire, right? So let's go back to our application here and let's run process PDFs to process those changes. Let's type in process PDFs. And there you go. It found the deleted blob. Let's go up into our logs here. It found the deleted blob. It found the Pinecone vectors with the IDs. And then it also removed those PDF embeddings from the index, such that now if I type the query, what is grit AI, I should get an updated response. So now I see a different response because turns out there is another PDF which had a similar definition. But as you can see, the reference that I get is very different from the reference that I got earlier when I ran this. As you can see, the reference here was my original file. And now that it has been deleted, I get an updated response with an updated reference. So with that, what we've seen is how you can effectively leverage change feed very easily from whichever application you're writing to deliver RAG and deliver freshness for your data and get current and updated responses from your knowledge base. All right, so we looked at how you can combine LangChain and Pinecone with Azure Blob Storage to deliver RAG. Wanted to give you a quick summary of what performance premium blob storage delivers for RAG applications. And as you can observe from this slide, across put blob, get blob operations, premium actually delivers 3x faster performance for retrieval augmented generation. And not just that, it also delivers 65% savings on transactions, which are so critical in these highly interactive applications where there is a lot of reads and writes coming in from the storage layer. With this, we have come to the end of this video tutorial where we showed you how you can leverage Azure Blob Storage to accelerate building RAG or retrieval augmented generation into your LLM applications. Blob Storage helps accelerate building these applications by integrating deeply with Azure AI services. It is interoperable with vector DBs and orchestrators with SDKs and tools. It offers low latency access to knowledge base and chunk data with premium blob storage. It offers security for your data with Azure Entra ID integration, RBAC and ABAC, and finally delivers the critical component of data freshness with change notification and change feed. Thank you so much for joining us for this video tutorial. Please do check out these helpful links in the description below and do check out our video on how you can leverage Azure Blob for not just RAG, but also fine-tuning your applications effectively using Azure Blob Storage. Thank you so much for watching.